Morning at Flight of Stalker Kura. Welcome to Tuesday. A little bit overcast today. I did say yesterday in my morning notices that there may be a bit of rain coming, and it didn't come. So I hope if I say the same thing, there may be a bit of rain coming, that it doesn't come and we get a good chance to get outside and play. Last week I talked about noticing the small things that you are grateful for. And as I was driving to work today, I noticed up Ahutakawa trees along Forest Hill Road especially are beginning to get their red flowers, which is always a sign that Christmas is just around the corner. And some of them are in full bloom and they're all red. Even our own Ahutakawa tree by the glade is beginning to get its red flowers starting to appear. So I'm really looking forward to the summer holidays. It's been a little bit of a tough year for all of us. So the summer holidays will be a chance to catch your breath, relax a little bit, and just recharge those batteries. But so when you're out and about, try and notice the Ahutakawa trees and see how many you can see that are just starting to get those red flowers. It's fantastic. It's a really beautiful part of our area that we've got so many Ahutakawa trees around. So let's have a great day of learning, everyone. Really enjoy yourselves, especially at morning tea and playtime. Ka kite anō.
Te tai wā. Gratefulness moments.
When Room 7 returned to school after our lockdown, there was a parcel waiting for them that said, what could it be? We played a little game to try to work out what could be inside by asking different questions. And then we played a game of pass the parcel to uncover what was inside. So when the music stopped, we did a little rip of the paper to start to unveil what was inside. There was a special treat for the children. Let's see what it is.
I didn't think I'd wrapped it that well. That's all right. Go. Oh, Jane. Big rip, Jane. Go on, rip. I tell you what, you might not have chosen the best piece. You might want to turn it over and try ripping from somewhere else.
Oh, yeah. I'm
going to
get that.
I want
it.
Go, man. Big rip, Madison. Come on.
That is hard.
Yeah. Oh, I can do a very good rip. I can do a very good rip. Oh,
no. Ready? I can go.
Do a very big rip.
I can do a double. Oh, Adam. Big rip.
Adam, start here.
No. Start
there.
Yeah, go. Yeah, go on. And again, keep going, Adam. I think we might pull it out. Pull it out, Adam. Hold it up. Oh. Is that cool?
So then it was a group challenge to construct the pirate ship.
Go. Oh, don't look where it goes then.
No!
Oh,
thank you.
This activity has required lots of different skills from the children, like working together and cooperation, taking turns, sharing, developing patience, as it took a long time to create, following instructions carefully, problem solving, amongst so many others.
Morena kura. Today is the second day of the FHS TV Ginger Bear short film competition, and we have a blast from the past. Literally, we're going back about 6 centuries to the deep dark ages of the Black Plague. Very fitting for this moment. And we're going to discover just what the real cause of that ancient pandemic was. Sit back and enjoy Werewolf Ginger Bear.
We find ourselves stuck in the deep, dark ages of the 14th century. The Black Plague has swept across Europe, leaving behind its devastation and death. Never before had anyone seen the scale of death and evil. Many thought it was unnatural event spread by the fleas of cats and dogs. Others believed there was a more sinister super spreader cause at play. Academics and alchemists across Europe worked tirelessly to find a cure without success. But it was the bravery of a small country village that would save the world from
Ah! My brother's got the werewolf virus! This will spread to the whole village and everyone will die! I have to find a cure to the virus! I gotta go see the witch doctor! 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 My brother Jeremiah has caught the werewolf virus! We need to find a cure, otherwise everyone will die horribly!
There's no known cure, but everyone has failed. But there's an old legend that says a cure for all illnesses can be found in a cave of the depths of the deep dark of the darkest dark foresters, but it's protected by a wickedly rabid wolf.
Isn't it meant to be rabid wolf?
Shush! Have a map and take you there.
Okay.
I still don't know. How do you float like that?
Oh, this place smells like a wet dog.
There it is. That's the cure. The cure to all illnesses. That was easier than I thought.
You shall not pass.
I need to. My brother's infected just like you.
My army grows.
I need it now.
You cannot have it. You will have to fight me.
I'll use my magic.
is the cure to all illnesses.
All good except the blood fell on the floor. Kia tau tō rangi marie, ki runga I ngā iwi o te ao.